So I think I have the privilege of giving the last presentation of the day. So I won't take too much of time. Thanks everyone on the dais to, you know, represent your companies as well as tell us about the different technologies that are existing in the market. My presentation is nothing to do with the technology, as I said earlier. So therefore I took a privilege of, you know, giving it as a last presentation. So we are a solar park company. Actually, there was one of the agenda in the discussion that someone should speak about what is an upcoming utility projects in the state and what's happening about it and how are we getting geared up for that. So here the discussion is all about, you know, throughout the day we have been listening about EPCs, the energy traders, the consumers and everything. Now behind this, there is something called as infrastructure that needs to be, you know, catered to. For larger solar parks, typically government provides that infrastructure. If the solar parks are of 50 megawatt onwards, it's government. But where do people go for the solar parks which are of 2 to 20 megawatt capacity or 2 to 50 megawatt capacity? In most of the tenders that we see currently in the country is like all these small scale solar parks, EPCs are being told that you fetch your own land, you fetch your own permission, you fetch your own connectivity and just bid. So ultimately no assistance being provided by the government. But at the same time, there is a pressure on them to bid at the same parity of pricing which they have done in Badla or Rewas and those things of the world. Now it becomes absolutely very difficult for EPCs whether to focus on their core business or go ahead with finding out the connectivities, getting land, getting the permissions, ROWs, transmission lines and whatnot. So that's where our company comes in. So as I said in the start, what is your core business? You focus on it. It's E, P and C. Okay. Getting land, getting permissions, going to the babus, all this is not your core business. Okay. And that is our core business. We do that because we provide solar parks where we create simple plug-and-play infrastructure. When we say a simple plug-and-play infrastructure, you come to our park, you decide that there is a 2 megawatt customer, a 5 megawatt customer, or whoever, okay? You have all of these things ready with us. Its infrastructure is ready, your land is ready, your connectivity is ready, your transmission line is ready, ROWs are in place, evacuation capacity is in place. So ultimately, the lead time that you can give to your customer is the lead time how much you take it to install your panels. Because for us, we have kept that ready. And in our solar park, we have different capacities for different EPCs. So not every EPC, it's no more a big boys club. The idea is to make sure that the smaller EPCs can also offer ground-mounted solutions to their customer from 2 to 20 megawatt, 2 to 30 megawatt, and then come to us to say that, okay, our customer is only 5 megawatt customer, but they want a ground-mounted, and where do we go? So ultimately, we will give that solution. And what we do in our park, we house such EPCs of different variations and different requirements and make a consortium of them to manage that particular solar park. So effectively, either we do the O&M or we ask the biggest EPC who has consumed the biggest share of that park to continue to do with the O&M. So we are quite flexible on that front. And therefore, when we say that solar park is no more only to be dependent on governments or on the bigger players, we have identified such opportunities across the state, whether if you take the the recent tender of Genco, MSCDCL, everyone is just going away from all those basic responsibilities of giving you a ready infrastructure. And that's what we are thinking, that we should be in a position to fill that gap. So you as a EPCs, as a manufacturers of various things, if at all you come across such customers where they want a housing facility, we are there and we will give you the plug and play environment that we promise. So currently we have our sites in Nagpur, Yavatmal, Wardha, so and many more in, you know, effectively we also go to Chhattisgarh. So we are trying to increase our footprint into the different states as well. So I'll not take more of your time. I'll ask panel to have some discussions, and I know that you know, whether it was a privilege or not, but this is the last presentation, so you will no longer be tortured for a slideshow anymore. Okay, thanks a lot for your time, and I'll ask open up the panel for the discussions. Okay, so throughout the day we have been listening about you know, what each of our companies have been doing, how good our companies are doing, how great the products are coming up. But unfortunately, throughout the day, I have not heard customer or a consumer as the king. So my question to all the panelists is, what should we as an ambassador to the customers guide our customer or help him educate to say that whenever you are going to go ahead with a rooftop or a ground mounted or whatever, okay, what are the things you should be looking for? It's not only price, okay, because price. And the thing is, our customers are not educated. And therefore, the only thing that they see is what is the price. I think there are other facets which he should be guided first, and then the real comparisons will start coming in. So I'll ask the distinguished panelists here, you know, one point each that will help the customer to say that what they should be looking for when they are making the choices of their solar systems. Doctor.
Yeah, thank you. This is the really good questions, and maximum time people really ask, okay, how much is the price? As I really explained in my presentations, the module need to be sustained for 25 years. And you really need to know what is inside of your modules. And really they can be go for 25 years. If you really try go for in this area, like don't ask the price, I need the quality and ensure that what are the materials inside which can be goes, and then I think the things will change. And I think that's the key.
Thanks. What's your opinion about it?
I think nowadays people are getting more educated, and they think before they ask. Like, I've seen that people are asking for quality, they're asking for the BOM, that they ask for the BOS, what are the materials that you're going to use in the, or what are the sites that you have installed. So I think customers are pretty much clear about the solar rooftops. They're asking for more and more questions to get them educate, and then we'll decide, like they'll decide.
Okay, thanks.
Well, as per me, customer should think first of safety. Am I getting a right component, whether it is safe, whether it will not create any hazard to the nature as well as the human being? That is the key factor. Instead of going for the decision with respect to the price, he should first see the safety. That's my opinion.
Okay, thank you.
Well, I think a customer need to understand which particular segment they are operating from. For example, for rooftop installation, you cannot seek price for ground mounted projects. So that's one key. And that also importantly, customer need to understand what are the products for that particular project, the correct project configuration with the higher quality products which will be will long last until the project life. So that's what they need to analyze, and then they need to ask Apple at the price of Apple, not the price of oranges.
Right.
I feel that some of the standards also need to be laid down. Some more detailing has to be done, because currently, if it is a price, only way to reduce the price is reduce the weight of the structure. As I said a couple of years back, it used to be 80 tons a megawatt, now it has come down to 26 tons a megawatt. So is it really worth going? Is it really competitiveness, or is it madness? That is what we need to draw a line somewhere. And some authority has to start fixing some details of the standards, yeah, beyond which, because everybody has got its own engineering detail, and who is going to see after 25 years, as everybody is saying, is it going to sustain, is it not going to corrode away what is going inside the material? So all these things have to be also established, and customers should also put pressure on the authorities to lay down the specification more elaborately, so that he can decide before deciding on the price alone.
Right. So there should be a minimum framework of, you know, safety, as you said, regarding the structures that they are putting in, whether they are environmental friendly or not, and all those things. And under that guidelines, everyone, every EPC should be adhering to. And that's what we should be telling to the customer. That's right.
I think by going solar, majority of the customers are trying to be green, but I think they need to really understand whether the product that has been manufactured or they're going to use it, is it really green? Has it been, you know, done in an environment-friendly way in terms of carbon footprint perspective? So that's the number one thing. So automatically that would take care of some of these, you know, the import duties and all those things, the issues are coming, those will get resolved because the customers will start becoming more conscious about it. That's number one. And number two is, of course, they should save water because we are putting in an arid region. So
absolutely.
By robots.
No, absolutely.
Yes, yeah, typically when we engage with the clients, we try to understand their perspective out of the what is the maximum, because I'm talking from the rooftop solar. So typical criteria for the clients there is, what is the maximum system potential in terms of kilowatt? What is the ease or the ease of installation and the ease of O&M? Then the generation numbers, because are they trying to be more independent in terms of lowering their energy bills? And longevity and functionality and aesthetics, of course, they come also in this. So out of these 5-6 major critical factors, which are the two most we identify for a client and try to give our value proposition based on that. And of course, price, for different price points, the value propositions will be offered. So that's our way of addressing the client's perspective.
That's right.
When it comes to customer, it definitely equation of price and quality, and again, the new innovations. But as far as innovations, research and development, all these things are, it is under our roof, it is inside of the factory. But when we go to the customer, it is definitely a war of price. And that is where I think it's my own lookout actually. We sometimes misunderstood the concept of price with the customer. Probably he wanted to say the affordability with the right equation of the quality. So I think we should focus on affordability with the right equation of the quality and duration of the product with the new innovations. So ultimately, absolutely, it should be an affordable product with well quality, with desirable, with the customer desire.
Desirable output, yeah. What he is expecting. Yeah, you're right. You know, most of the time we take our product, whether it is fitting the bill or not, it is just like, you know, previous days where LIC agent would come and, you know, sell you the policy, which is of no use to you whatsoever. Similar thing seems to be happening in the industry, which will kill the industry, and the customers are day by day becoming suspicious with every solar salesman these days. It's like, you know, window salesman in Western world, everyone is suspicious about their job. So I think it is becoming our responsibility also to educate the customer, at the same time guide them for, as you correctly said, as what is his affordability and what is the requirement? Your view, sir.
I see that ethical value should be more of a thing, because absolutely, people are all cutting down the cost to bring down the cost. See, end of the day, your price, what you buy, will be forgotten, but the quality will be remembered forever.
Right.
So what I think is, people should be ethical in what they do, and don't compromise on the prices, have a margin. So that will be a mantra for a long run.
Right. Ethics of the business is going to be a long-term mantra. Right. Yeah, I have been ignoring the audience. Here you go, sir.
Yeah, okay. So talking of customer, I think we should be asking customer and not telling them.
No, the question what is should... about educating some of the customers.
Sure. But the point that I want to make is, you know, at the ground level, it really needs to come out from the customer. Say, suppose I am a customer and I need a solar lamp, you know, simple thing. Then if the product manufacturer tells me that you have to put the panel out in the sun, clean it every day, I'm not going to like it, okay? So as a customer, what I want is a inbuilt panel which is self-cleaning and whatever, okay? So right, these things really have to come from customer, that is what I think.
Yeah, I totally agree that if he is the buyer, then he has to specify his requirement as well. Anyone else would like to have any questions to the panelists? Sir. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, you are the only.
Usually customers want the moon, but it's sometimes not possible. I'm an inverter. I'm from an inverter manufacturing company. I'll share an experience with you, and it happened to me about 11, 12 days ago.
Yeah.
We supplied some inverters to a client, and they lied to our face that our inverters, when they reached them, did not have certain components. That's completely impossible. And 2 days after, they're connecting with my engineer how to install that, and the installation cannot happen with that. So they want everything, but it is not possible to give them everything. So I don't completely agree to the fact that we should go to the customer, because they live in a fantasy world. What is required in the market has to be developed by us. I think most of the industry is sitting over here. We know it much better, and usually the customer has a double PhD in everything that we know.
Right.
So they kind of undermine us, tell us what they want, which is space age technology. Okay, self-cleaning panels and everything. It takes work and effort to maintain a solar system, or even a solar lantern, as a matter of fact. So it is something that it is our responsibility to enforce this, rather than just educate the customer. Okay, this is what is available, this is what is required, and this is what will satisfy you. Don't think about the moon. That is about 10 years down the line. So this is something that I would like to tell everybody over here. Thanks.
Absolutely. Okay. Yes, sir. I think.
Is your cameras compatible with the drones so that we can cover more areas in a shorter span?
Yeah, these cameras are available with different field of view angle. So you can choose the wide angle lens for the camera, and you can have wider view so that you can cover more number of modules at a time. And then first you take the image from far off, and then when you find the hotspot, then only you can go close and do some detail analysis. It is possible.
But it's only possible when we can control it remotely. So is your cameras, we can control it from remotely?
Yes.
To click the shot?
Yes, yes. The model which we have kept outside, it has got a Wi-Fi connectivity. One can hold the camera and other person can see the thermal pictures, thermal video streaming on the mobile handset or iPad or something like that. And he can take the image whenever he feels there is a hotspot or there is some problem.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
Any further questions from anyone over here? Okay, so I think we are fairly dot on time on that. So before I hand over the mic to Anand, you know, let me thank you and EQ for organizing these things all over the years, effectively, you know, and successfully giving a platform to all of us, okay? So our thanks to you and EQ on behalf of everyone. We would want you to continue with this journey for him.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, distinguished speakers on the dais. It's definitely a pleasure to keep on serving the solar industry. And the journey has been definitely incredible. When we started 9 years ago, I think most of us had no clue as to where really this revolution is headed towards. And now, definitely, the industry is very, very interesting to watch. One of the biggest landmark revolutions that the entire human civilization is going to witness in this century. So we hope to serve the industry in a better possible manner, and we're open for any feedbacks and more customization. So feel free to contact us for this. Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the speakers of this session. It was quite enlightening, very, very enriching. Thank you very much. I'll now request our session chair and moderator to present small mementos to all the session speakers.
So it's on your behalf, so you should be able to do that.